Welcome to the Flutter Calendar tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to customize the date picker widget's appearance in the Syncfusion Flutter Calendar widget. I will also show you how to disable the default header and add a custom date picker widget to the calendar to customize its appearance. I'm using an example application that was configured with the Syncfusion Flutter Calendar to show the date picker button. Also, I have changed the today highlight color, background, and selection border color. To learn how to integrate the calendar widget into a Flutter application, please check out the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application in an Android emulator. You can see the calendar with a white background, and today's date and selection colors in green. Notice that the header background color is still in default light violet. I click the date picker button and the current date is green, but the date picker background is default light violet. Next, I'll show you how to customize the theme for this date range picker using the Syncfusion Flutter date range picker widget. I will disable this default header and add a text button widget to customize the header theme. First, let me add the custom header by modifying the scaffold to use a column widget. Wrap the calendar within a column. Add an expanded widget and set its child as the calendar to fill the available space. Within the column's children collection, add a row widget. In its children collection, add an expanded widget and set its child with a container. I set the color to white. This will fill the entire header with a white background. Then, align the container to the top left. To its child, add a text button and set its child to a text widget. This should show the month and year details. Now, I'll provide a string value and later update this value dynamically, retrieving it from the calendar widget. Align the text to the center and set style with font size and color. Add the onPressed argument with an empty function. I will implement this also later. I add the cons keyword since the text is not dynamically updated right now, and remove it from the text style because its parent is itself a constant widget. Now you can see the defined text button with the provided text and a white background. Let me hide this default header. In the calendar widget, I set the header height to 0. Now the default header is not visible, and the custom header is rendered. Next, let me dynamically set the month and year values in the text button. In the My Home Page State class, define a string variable header text. In the text button, I set the header text variable instead of the string value. In the calendar widget, add the onViewChanged event by receiving a parameter. Ensure that the visible dates collection is not empty and set the first visible date to the header text after formatting. To format the date, I import the intel package in the pubspec YAML file. Now I can import the library. This will provide the month and year details at runtime. I need to update this header text variable after the calendar's visible date range has been rendered. So I use the scheduler binding instances add post frame callback and call set state within it. This ensures the UI update is done after the initial rendering is complete. I remove this cons keyword since I am dynamically updating the text and will add it to the style. You can see the month and year details updated dynamically. Next, let me show how the date range picker is displayed when I press this text button. In the text button's onPress function, call a function by passing the context as an argument. Implement the function. Within it, I use the showDialog function to show the date range picker above the current contents. In the builder function, pass the context as an argument and return a center widget. Add a size box and set its width and height using the context parameter. This will cause the dialog size to be less than the current builder context. Now I need to add the date range picker with a custom theme. First, I need to import the necessary packages. In the pub spec YAML file, add the Syncfusion Flutter core package that contains the date range picker theme related classes and Syncfusion Flutter date picker package to get the widget. In the size box, add the child as a date range picker theme. In its attribute, set the date range picker theme data and set its background and header background colors to white. Apply the selection and today highlight color properties to green, which is provided in the calendar component. Set the today cell and header text style properties to black and font size 20. In the child attribute, set the date range picker widget. When I press the text button, the date range picker pops up, and you can see that today's date is highlighted with the provided green color and the selection color is customized. Next, let me show you how to update the calendar when a date is selected from the date range picker. In the date range picker widget, use the onSelectionChanged event, get the currently selected date value, and store it in a variable. I define the variable in the class to use it in the calendar. To bind this selected date to the calendar widget, I need to create a calendar controller object. I define a calendar controller object. In the calendar widget, set its controller property with the newly created object. In the date range picker widget's on selection changed function, set the calendar controller's display date with the selected date. Use the navigator widget to pop the parent context. This will show the calendar widget after selection. I press the text button and select a different date. The selected date is bound to the calendar. I press the text button. You can see the currently selected date has not been updated to the date range picker. So, in the My Home Page State class, define a date range picker controller object. In the Text Buttons on Press function, I set the date picker controller's display date with the selected date. In the date range picker widget, set its controller property with the newly created object. I press the text button and choose a different date. The selected date is bound to the calendar. Again, when I check the date range picker's current selection, it is correctly bound with the custom theme. Let's see how the same code works in a web browser. I'll stop the application, change the device name to Chrome, and run the application. You can see the custom range picker button with the provided custom colors. I click it, and you can see the new theme in the date range picker. I select a date. The selected date is bound to the calendar. When I click again, the date range picker's current selection is updated as expected. Finally, let me show you how this works on the desktop. Change the device to Windows and run the application. You can see the new theme in the header and in the date range picker UI. Let me summarize this video. I have shown you how to customize the date picker's appearance in the Syncfusion Flutter Calendar widget. You can download the example in this video from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key for all our Flutter products. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.